Hi everyone, Trax again, now with an addition to my leveling inscription in 17 steps video, a little and quick guide in what to expect when you're milling herbs in Legion. To give you a good indication or a clear view in what to expect, I milled down 2000 pieces of the normal herbs, that is Ephril, Dreamleaf, Foxflower, Fjarnskagel and Starlight Rose. And because of the rarity and the cost price, I milled down 200 Felworth as well. So for starters, I'm taking off with Ephril and Dreamleaf. Ephril on the left and Dreamleaf on the right. And as you can see right away, in addition to the crafting regions, roseate pigments and the more expensive sallow pigments, you also receive acerline seeds from all the herbs. There is just a small twist for every herb. With Ephril, you receive in addition to the previous mentioned regions some extra gem chips. And for Dreamleaf on the right, you receive Nightmare Pods, which I'm going to open after the initial milling is completed. From 2000 Ephril, I receive 36 gem chips, 81 acerline seeds, 101 sallow pigments, and 836 roseate pigments. From Dreamleaf, I received 48 Nightmare Pods, 78 acerline seeds, 100 sallow pigments, and 842 roseate pigments. Now, to open the Nightmare Pods, these contain a big amount of both pigments and also some more acerline seeds. And from opening 48 Nightmare Pods, I received an additional amount of 12 acerline seeds, totaling up to 90. 115 roseate pigments totaling up to 957, and last but not least a staggering 146 sallow pigments, which is more from the milling itself, totaling the sallow pigments up to 246 from 2000 Dreamleaf. For the second part, we have Foxflower on the left and Fjarnskagel on the right. Compared to both Ephril and Dreamleaf, other than the two pigments and acerline seeds, these two herbs have no additional loot like gem chips and nightmare pods coming out of milling. What we do see is that we receive a lot more acerline seeds from Foxflower than on the other herbs, 522 to be exact, and I also received 837 roseate pigments and 89 sallow pigments. Then looking to Fjarnskagel, which is shown to be the most baseline herb, receiving 72 acerline seeds, 938 roseate pigments and 90 sallow pigments. So far from milling down the first four herbs, it seems to be, except for opening the nightmare pods, that the pigments received are all within the same range of each other. So with the nightmare pods added in the total so far, Dreamleaf is going to be the best herb for the job. Which brings us to herb number 5, Starlight Rose. Now I know what you think, why counting Starlight Rose as a normal herb, while you can only gather them in single pieces and the others in multiple numbers. Well, it all has to do with the WoW economy and how World of Warcraft works. While you can only herb them in single pieces, we all spend a big amount of time in Suramar, which leaves the more firm herbalists with a huge amount of roses after finishing the questline and when you consistently gather all herbs you come across. Also, with a market value of 40 gold, it's even cheaper than the 44 gold one needs to pay for Foxflower on my server. Just like the two previous herbs, Starlight Rose also hasn't got additional regions coming with milling. Both acerline seeds with 67 and sallow pigments with 90 are within line of the previous four herbs. But then we see the stacks of roseate pigments, 2457 to be exact, and to be expected as you look at both names, Roseate Pigments and Starlight Rose. Now for the final part, you could have seen a bit of Felworth milling in the footage that I made while making the 17 steps video, where I milled down 150 Felworth, but as to be expected from the most rare and most expensive herb in Legion, mostly received sallow pigments. Acerline seeds with 11 and roseate pigments with 83 are the lowest, but sallow pigments are simply amazing with 423, which is more than two pigments for every Felworth. Moving on to my personal guild bank, and now that we are on the bank tab with all of the received regions, the top line is Ephril with baseline loot and a small addition of gem chips. The second line is Dreamleaf, which was baseline until I opened up the Nightmare Pods, giving a bigger amount of sallow pigments. Foxflower Online 3 has the same numbers when it comes to Solo Pigment and Roseate Pigments, but a higher loot of Acerolang Seeds, Fjernskagel, the most baseline herb with no additional regions. Line 5 from Starlight Rose is the one with the amazing result on Roseate Pigments, and the final one, Fellworth, is with the biggest result of Solo Pigments. Now, for my opinion, I would leave Fjernskagel out of milling. I would definitely go for Dreamleaf as a farming herb, especially with how easy it is to farm in Chalanir. I'll make sure I'll link that video in the ending screen together with the leveling inscription video. And not only I would suggest Dreamleaf as a farming herb, but also Fellworth for Solo Pigments. So whenever you see a world quest which awards you Fellworth, go ahead, go and grab it. Do that world quest, get that bonus Fellworth. Now, a while ago, I think it was a month or two ago, Ifril was the most golden herb, bringing in the most profit since it was so cheap at the time. Fellworth is a good investment when you have the gold to do so, and a better source of gold when and only when regents and crafts from inscriptions sell. So far, I can only recommend selling Tomes of the Tranquil Mind. Being only level 107, I haven't started on the Vanity Runes, which you loot mostly from raid bosses. And the glyphs from Legion, which I collected and crafted so far, well, none of them sold so far. My friend Jemadar, who also subbed to my channel, is monitoring his sales in Vanity Runes, but so far no luck there. I'll cover Vanity Runes in another video other than this, because otherwise it will be too long and it's a more specific subject. I hope this video learned you a thing or two about milling and it was helpful for you. If so, don't forget to support me by giving that like. For any questions and requests, even on other topics, feel free to use the comment section, and you can show some love by hitting that sub button for more content and videos. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all next time.